So I recently picked up a box of these coasters from Amazon. These are Slate. I believe I got a dozen of these for about $22. So it works out to be less than $2 each, which is not bad. These particular coasters seem like they're pretty good quality. They are 4 inches in diameter. The edges are a little bit rough. They are a natural cut. So I would say your flat workable surface on these is probably about 3 5/8 of an inch, which is plenty. You'll be able to put a real nice size burning in there, a logo, a monogram, whatever you want to do. So if you stick around, I'm going to show you how I find the center of this coaster and then how I set up my laser XYZ Zero off of that. Then I will run my speed and power test, show you the results of that, and then finally I will actually burn my file. So stick around. So I'll give you a close-up of these coasters. There are a couple of weird imperfections. I don't know if that's some sort of, I'm not sure what that is, some kind of iridescence. I'm not sure, but this one I will just use for my speed and power test. That way if it ends up showing through or I don't like the way it works out, it's okay because it's just my test. So I'm going to set this up and I'm going to show you guys how I set this up and how I find zero, and then we will go from there. First thing I'll do, just to make it a little bit easier to see, I will take a piece of my masking tape and I'll put it roughly where I think center is going to be. Okay, I picked myself up one of these off of Amazon. This is a circle center finder. If you look there, it'll tell you all the sizes of your circles. So all you need to do then is lay this on your coaster or whatever actually you want to mark, and then you can just set this up and mark your center. So I'll show you how that works. Here's my coaster set up. I will take my center finder, and I know that we are roughly 4 inches, so I will get it pretty close to 4 inches there. I will make sure that I've got this as close as I can. It's going to look a little bit weird on camera because it's going to look like I'm not lined up correctly, but I assure you that from the top, an actual perfect angle of this, that I am right down the center. So once I like that, I will set that up, give that a quick mark, and there's my mark. If it doesn't come out dark enough, you can darken it, and there we go. So now when I set my laser up, I will set it for that point exactly, and I know that I am center of my coaster. All right, first things first. They give you this little setup bar here with your JTEC laser. It's basically an 1/8 of an inch piece of acrylic. So you set that on your work surface, and then you jog your laser over to the center of that. Okay, so then all you need to do now is lower your laser so that it just touches the surface of that 1/8 inch spacer block there. When you get close, you can hit your blue button to slow down. Okay, and that's it right there. I've got my Z set now. Now that I've got my Z set, I can go ahead and turn the laser on and find my X and Y. So in order to do that, you click this MDI, then you click there in the box, and now you're going to tell it a command. You're going to tell it M3. That tells the laser to turn on. Then you hit S. S is for your power. So I found that if I run this at 18 or 20, we'll try 18 first. That will give me just a small beam of light, and that will allow me to use my joypad to jog it back and forth and find my XY0. So I'm going to hit enter. Doesn't do anything yet till you hit play. So I'm going to hit play, and then I'll bring you over to the laser. So there is that very faint laser. So now I will just use the joypad, and I will jog this back into space till I can find my center mark. You can see it right there, about 1/4 inch over. Okay, and that's it. I'm right on top of my center mark there. So then I will come back over to my joypad here. All right, now that I've got that set up, I will click in here. I will type M5. That is the command to turn the laser off. I will hit enter. Then I will hit play. And now you can see the laser is off. So now that I know I have center, I'll scroll down. I will zero my X, zero my Y, but I will not touch the Z because I already set that with my setup bar. And now I'm ready to cut. So before you cut, you need to jog your laser out of the way, peel off that piece of tape, and run your file. So I've got my tape peeled off. So I'll come back up here to my controller. I will hit that target. It'll say move to the XY origin. I will say yes. Okay, and now I'm exactly where I want to be. So I'm going to run my speed and power test, and then I will show you the results. The laser is finished running my speed and power test. So now I will move my laser out of my way and show you the results. So it's kind of inconclusive. They all look pretty similar. I guess if you wanted maybe something a little lighter, you could go there, but pretty much any of the ones in that range are all pretty much the same. So when you run these, you obviously you want to run your laser as fast as you possibly can and get the correct burn in. So that way you're saving time. So I think I'm going to run my next file at 50 and 100. I think that'll give me a nice color and a nice burn. So I'm going to set up one more coaster. That'll be my actual file, and I will show you the laser doing its thing. See how the laser did? Well, that turned out awesome. That's exactly what I wanted there. It actually looks almost a little bit gold. I didn't really expect that, but that is super cool. Wonder if I can adjust that with my speed and power, but I am definitely loving the way this turned out. Best part is that is etched into there, so that will never come off. Gonna add a quick clear coat with some spray polyurethane, probably just some water base, but I love this. Now I'm gonna have to do a Mario and Luigi, maybe a princess, have a full set of four. So if you guys are getting value from these videos, please give me a thumbs up and a subscribe. Drop me a comment down below. Let me know what you think or something you'd like to see in the future. And until next time, take it easy.